Hi. Yeah, good to see you again today. Yeah. So it's been like about a week, you know,
yeah,
after the surgery, right?
Yeah.
So how do you feel about it?
I'm feeling pretty good, actually. You know, yeah. I mean, I think post surgery, the first couple of days, it was quite hard, but that's expected.
Mm.
But now, you know, I'm moving a bit more, and I can walk around more, I can do more. I'm actually quite surprised how quickly.
When I saw you there, you are much, I mean, better, and yeah, it's a perfect, very normal.
Yeah. I'm actually quite surprised.
Yeah. You must be, because you are flying back to London tomorrow, right?
Yes, it's going to be a long flight, so I was obviously a bit worried.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. But now that I'm feeling a lot better, I'm more confident now.
Some years ago, I went to London.
Yeah,
it was a long and long flight.
It is a long flight.
Never stop, you know. From here there, it's a long, the longest flight I ever taken in my life.
It's about
12 hours. That's right. Yeah. Even I go to USA, sometimes 7-8 hours I arrive in LA or Seattle, like that. Even New York.
Yeah.
I think it's less than London, I guess, the time.
Yeah,
it's about the same, maybe, you know. But I just been to USA many times, no problem. But London, it was a really longest one I've ever experienced.
Yeah, the quickest you get there is like 11-12 hours, but sometimes you have to make a
stop over
or a connecting flight, which is longer.
Okay, so it is your first time coming to Korea, right?
It is my first time. Okay. Obviously, I would prefer to visit Korea for another reason.
Oh, okay.
But it's still been a good experience.
Okay.
I mean, because it's my first time, and obviously this is my first hernia.
That's right. Yeah,
my family was a little bit worried. You can understand.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, of course. You know.
Yeah, from the UK to Korea, it's a long trip, and they're worried if there's any complications on. By myself so far.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
You know, so my mom was really like, stay in the UK.
And if I were your family, I would have the same worry as your mom had. Yeah. So we just want to know your hernia problem from the beginning, and then how you have a surge, the doctors or hospitals, you know.
Okay.
Like, we really want to know.
Okay. So I was getting pain. Because of the hernia.
When?
I think it was maybe a couple of months now.
Oh, a couple of months?
Yeah,
okay.
A couple of months. But the doctors didn't find out what it was until a month later. Because of the pain, I wasn't sure what it was or where it was coming from.
Oh, I see.
So after some tests, an ultrasound, they found the inguinal hernia on my right side. And they said, so with this, you have to get surgery to get it repaired.
That's your doctor in London, right?
In London.
Okay.
They said you have to get a surgery because then they don't know it by themselves.
Oh, I see.
So after that, I did a bit of research into what exactly a hernia is.
Mm.
And so I also found that there's different treatment, surgery methods.
Different surgery methods.
There's different methods.
Okay.
There's obviously the non-mesh, and then with mesh.
Oh, yeah.
And so I found out in the UK, 90% of the surgeries is performed on the mesh.
Oh, 90% with mesh, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And so, I read about there were stories about complications with mesh.
Oh yeah, right.
But obviously it's not a big percentage. It's a very small percentage with people who have problems with mesh. But I think it's still a big enough problem that I didn't really want to take a risk.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So therefore, I just researched where I can find a doctor or a surgeon who could perform the repair without the mesh, because if I had a choice, I'd rather not have something foreign in my body.
Yes, that's right, yeah.
Because I'm worried if it's, by the time if you find out something is wrong, it's already too late.
Oh yeah, right.
Yeah. So I researched online. I found a couple of surgeons in the UK, I believe, already retired.
Non-mesh surgeons.
Non-mesh.
But they are retired.
Yeah, right?
Retired. Okay.
Right. And so I thought, okay, I have to widen my search. So I have to search internationally.
Okay.
You know, because I'm willing to travel.
Okay.
So I found a hospital also in Canada, the Shoreline.
Ah, yes, that's a really famous hospital.
It's a very famous hospital, yeah. And I did a lot of research. I made some calls, and finally I stumbled across a forum, a hernia forum.
Oh yeah, hernia talk.
Hernia
talk, right? Okay, yeah. Hernia talk.
Yeah, and I found a patient, I think.
Jack Wilkinson, right?
Wilkinson.
Yeah, that's the bike rider.
Right.
From the
US.
USA, right.
And I did a bit more reading.
Okay.
And I found that he, in the US, he also, I think, went in the newspapers.
That's right.
Yeah.
That is a mesh news desk, right?
Right.
That is another kind of a forum or kind of a website.
Yeah. For, yeah. So this piqued my interest. So I found Dr. Kang, his name.
Oh.
So I did some more reading on Dr. Kang.
Okay.
And I found, I like his idea, his philosophy.
Oh, okay.
So I found out that he used to do many hernia repairs, with and without mesh.
Mm-hmm.
And he realized that, you know, there are complications that come with the mesh.
That's right.
So I decided, okay, I think this is the life, I think this is the one.
Mm-hmm.
He's done both.
That's right.
And he's got many years of experience.
Yes.
And he has a hospital. So it's a specialized hospital. I spoke to my family, and again, they said, well, why do you have to travel so far? I'm not comfortable with you going so far.
Mm-hmm.
And so my mother, she said, if you really have to go, I'll come with you. And you know, my mum, she's great, she's in good health, but I don't want her to travel so far.
That's right, yeah.
For
yeah, that's right.
I said to her, I'll be okay.
Yeah, that's right, yeah, that's yeah. Right, yeah. So your decision was very quick, you know?
I was worried. Of course, anyone would be worried.
Okay.
I'm glad. I'm happy I made the decision. And
yes.
I'm feeling a lot better.
Okay. And since the surgery, it's been about a week, you said that. What you have done for about a week up until now?
The first
surgery.
Yeah, the first couple of days, I tried not to move around too much because it was quite, it's too fresh afterwards.
That's right.
And, I just stayed. I just tried to rest as much as I can, eat properly. And but each day I would slowly get stronger and slowly get better.
Okay.
And you know, the better I get, the more I want to do. So I start to walk a little bit further each day.
Uh-huh.
You know, just enough. But you have to listen to your body. You can't.
That's right. Yeah.
You can't push it too much.
Mm-hmm.
So every day, you know, bit by bit, I would maybe explore the area. But now I feel like I can go a lot further and do a lot more, and you know, my appetite is pretty good now. I'm not jet lagged anymore.
So what do you want to say to those who suffer from hernias in the world?
Suffering from hernia?
Yeah.
I would say do research.
Yes.
Do your research. You know, just be aware that you have a choice.
Uh-huh.
You know, with if you choose to go with a non-mesh or whether you choose to go with a traditional mesh now, just remember you have a choice, but then think about the benefits and maybe complications.
I see.
Obviously now, you know, most of the world, we practice using the mesh now.
Okay.
So the problems that come with the mesh, it's small. Obviously it's very small, but it still needs to be taken into consideration.
That's right, okay.
Yeah.
Well, finally, can you talk about the cost comparison, you know, and what is your the benefit, you know, to have surgery in this country or in UK or in European countries anywhere? You know, what do you think about that?
I think the system here is very quick.
Yes.
That's right.
It's all you just one stop. I mean, service yes. like that. Yeah.
I was very surprised. Very quick. I think if people decide to go with a non-mesh method, I think Korea is a good choice. I can vouch.
In terms of money spending.
In terms of money spending, it's actually I find it quite. It's very reasonable.
Okay.
Yeah. It's actually cheaper than some places in London if you go private.
Oh.
So okay. It's very very reasonable. The service is very quick, very good.
Okay.
And like I said, I'm glad I took the chance to come here.
Okay.
You know, and if I hope nobody I know would develop a hernia, but if they did, I would recommend Korea.
It's
the price is reasonable, the service is very quick, and
okay.
I felt very well looked after.
Okay.
You know, it's not just you come do the surgery and then you can leave and that's it. We don't hear from you again. It's
mm-hmm.
you know you've been calling to see if I'm okay and
okay.
It's, yeah, I feel very well looked after. I told my family and they feel really relieved and happy.
Okay.
And like I said, my mum would like to see.
Oh right, that's really good. Okay, that's really good. Okay, so. In the beginning, your sister came
yes.
together with you and helping you a lot, actually. Right?
Yes,
yeah.
yes. Because she's based in Hong Kong.
Oh right,
so,
yeah.
So the trip here is not too far.
Yeah.
And I did say, you know, I would feel more confident with someone here to be by my side, just to watch me.
Right.
And also, my family in the UK, they'll be happier with.
That's right.
Someone
yeah.
watching over
okay, yeah. She invited me to London.
Yes, of course. So when you come back to London, you know,
okay.
we'll be happy to take you around.
Okay, well, thank you very much. And wish you have a real good journey back to London tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This interview has been done at Peito Hotel Gangnam, where Pai has stayed. Here and I really thank Hai and thank you everyone. Bye.